today, three VIP titans decide the fate of our rising entrepreneurs.
I know that you mean well, but this is a business, right? I'm sorry.
How big can this business be?
Determined to prove their greatness in 60 seconds or less.
But I'll tell you, for one, that's a non-starter for me.
Oh, no.
This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business with support from State Farm. Meet our board of investors, CeeLo Green, Grammy Award-winning singer, songwriter, and producer. Kim Perrell, serial entrepreneur and tech CEO of 100.co. Mark Randolph, co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. Hoping to satisfy the investors' stomachs is an entrepreneur and her delicious organic pancake mix.
Hello, Tiffany. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
2 years ago, I walked away from a successful six-figure sales career. Inspired by my grandfather's legacy of farming and a recipe for my kitchen table, I decided to bet on myself. I'm Tiffany Neal, founder of Barlow's, based out of Atlanta. Our 3-in-1 pancake, biscuit, waffle mix, and syrups make breakfast better, healthier, and easier for food service professionals and families. Now more than ever, consumers are making decisions based off quality, and we have the traction to prove it. With a 95% annual growth rate, we're in 100 retailers without any distribution. With your investment, we are determined to be the obvious choice in breakfast. Our ask is for $150,000 in the form of a safe to assist with manufacturing and expanding our reach. So who's with me? Let's make Barlow's a household brand.
That was pretty strong.
I think so too.
Yeah. She did a good job.
I mean, she came right in. She kind of laid out what the product was, what the differentiation was. The ask was for the amount. I didn't quite hear what the cap was going to be on the safe note, but you know, you can't have everything right.
And she's from my hometown, Atlanta, Georgia.
She's early on, so I guess the question we have to ask ourselves, how big can this business be? Why do I buy her pancake mix over someone else's?
I'm a little distracted, baby, because look at me, man. I love a good pancake. I think we should vote.
Well, I'm up for that.
Let's do it.
Attention, Tiffany. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Hey. Home girl.
Tiffany.
Hello, hello, everyone.
Hello.
Congrats. Welcome to the boardroom. You had the unanimous thumbs up from all three of your investors, so off to a good start.
Thank you so much.
And I will say, I love a good pancake as much as the rest guy, but I'm curious if these are silver dollar pancakes, if you know what I mean. I'm really curious, is this an investment that can make money for me? Give me a sense of what the scale is here. What's your revenue now?
First year we launched, we did an amazing $8,000 in sales. Second year, we did about $40,000 in sales. And third year, we're at about $80,000 in sales. And 12-year trail of about $120,000. And we're projected to do $500,000 this year.
This year?
This year.
Wow.
Yes.
Awesome.
That's amazing.
And is this still a kind of a homegrown business?
So it did start in my kitchen. I work out of a commercial space, so I have a lean team, but we've launched, we sold out on QVC last year. It was a really big deal for us. We're more of a premium product, so we're not your just add water or your regular schmegular, you know, pancake mix at the local grocery store. We believe in ingredients. We lead with those ingredients. So high quality, organic, unbleached, unenriched.
In my household, we don't talk about food. We eat it. Let's try some.
Absolutely. Let me get y'all a sample. So there's one for you.
Thank you.
There you go.
Which one am I tasting?
So you're going to sample our peach cobbler syrup, which is a seasonal syrup available in the summertime, along with the pancakes that are made with the pancake biscuit and waffle mix.
It's so good.
Thank you so much.
What do I know about pancakes and syrup besides eating it? But I got to say, the syrup is highly differentiated.
It is. It's delicious.
Thank you so much.
So what are you going to use the money you're raising for?
So the money is going to be used to increase our manufacturing capabilities and then also to help extend our reach through distribution, because we want to be the obvious choice in the Southeast and eventually everywhere, right?
What was the ask again?
$150 in the form of a safe.
$150,000 in the form of safe. And was there a cap on the safe?
So uncapped at
10%. Oh, Mark is going to kill you. If you say uncapped, Mark's like taps out every time. Oh!
You just said the magic words.
Oh, no.
So an uncapped safe is kind of a screw job, basically, in my opinion. Not to be too harsh.
Okay.
Because basically, let's say it takes you 3, 4, 5 years to get some traction, to finally do a round, and the round gets priced at $300 million. Congratulations. Well, my investment that I made 5 years earlier is now priced at that valuation. That's not fair.
Okay.
So I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet, but I'll tell you, for one, that's a non-starter for me.
I like to be fair.
So what's the true valuation for where you are today?
So right now, 2.5.
There we go. Okay.
Yeah, now we're talking.
Tell me this. Is it typically sold as a package deal, a companion piece? You could rightfully have the pancake mix without the syrup, right?
You can. So we sell direct to consumer on our website at barlowsfoods.com, and you can purchase bundles. You get a little bit of a deal there. Mm. When we sell wholesale, it's either by a case of syrup or by a case of mix.
Tiffany, I love everything about you. I love your hustle. I love that you started this, that you took a jump into the unknown and didn't know what was gonna happen, and that you've made a very good business. And now it's time to take it to the next level. But there's still a lot of work to do.
Yes.
So at this point, I'm willing to invest $100,000 at the 2.5 million cap. Mm. I'm willing to make a bet on you because you made a bet on yourself.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
It is awesome to see you putting your money where your mouth is.
It was delicious, Mark.
I think so,
So I'm going to make it easy here. I'll clear the field for you, Kim, because I also really love your hustle. I love what you've built, and I clearly love the product. What I don't love is it's going to be a market product, and I do know how brutal it is to stand out in a supermarket. You have a shelf full of syrup, you have a shelf full of pancake mix, and wow, it's just hard for me to see a way to this is gonna be the one that transcends them all. So unfortunately, I pass.
Thank you so much.
I am involved exclusively in a couple of different ventures locally in Atlanta as well, but it's a community of us, and you are very welcome. I would like to befriend you, introduce you, and you can have that village of support and love, you know, and we could carry that product in some of these other, you know, venues, you know, and support you in that way, and free of charge, just love.
Well, thank you so much.
Because you're the homegirl.
That's right.
Okay? But as far as a formal engagement, I'm going to pass. I feel the girl power. I think Kim should give it the best go.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
For sure.
It's pretty clear now. CeeLo's out. I'm out, and on the table, you have Kim's offer, $100,000, a capped note of $2.5 million. What are you gonna do?
So I'm definitely taking the good wheel, but I'm gonna go with my girl Kim. I've seen what you can do, but my only ask is, do you think that we can do 150 at the 2.5 cap?
Hmm. I love that you asked, because if you don't ask, you don't get. So my proposal is this. I will invest $100K now, and once you hit that $500K that you budgeted for this year, I'll put in the extra 50 on the same terms.
Okay, you have a deal.
Mm. Well done to me.
Great deal.
I'm so excited.
Yes, me too.
Thank you so much.
Guys, I'm gonna have a few more pancakes on the way out here, just a saying. They're so good.
Thank you so much. Enjoy.
Yes, cheers. Oh. So excited to do business together.
Very excited. Thank you so much. I can't wait to
go,
work
girl.
With you too.
Congratulations.
Kim is a beast. She has done amazing things for so many CPG companies across the board. So I'm super, super excited just to work with her, to learn from her, and to hopefully have that success that she's had with some of those other products and brands that she's worked with.
Honestly, she's a good bet. She made her own investment. She made the jump. It's hard. She knows it's going to be hard, but she's got hustle, grit, and I think she's a surefire win. So I'm excited, and I love pancakes. A strong pitch can only go so far. At the end of the day, I'm counting on you to know every single detail of your business. And if there's a hole in your business model, I'm counting on you to solve it. So if you don't have the expertise and you haven't surrounded yourself with someone that does, I'm out.
Next up, an entrepreneur plans to cleanse the world of toxic chemicals found in personal care products.
Hello, Kelly. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Kelly. When I started this company in my basement, I didn't realize that I was going to become an activist. But then I learned that only 1 in 5 people recycles their personal care packaging, which equates to over 120 billion units of packaging in landfills every year. I learned about the microplastics that are in our bloodstreams, and I saw firsthand the devastation caused by ocean waste plastics for our marine life. I knew I couldn't stand on the sidelines anymore. Spinster Sisters Co. is a B Corp and woman-owned certified personal care brand, focusing on eliminating all the things we should not be putting on our bodies or into the environment. Our products are formulated with pure plant-based ingredients, all delivered in home compostable packaging. Together with the over 4,000 stores that sell our products around the country, we have eliminated over 370,000 plastic units. We're seeking $500,000.
What happened at the end there?
Yeah, it was.
Hit 60 seconds and that was it.
Let's just say we heard her say 20%.
I like the cause, I like where she's going with it, and she's had traction, 4,000 stores. For me is how much money has she made?
Well, she sent a signal, and I listen, maybe I'm biased this way, but when someone starts off talking about how good it is for the planet, which is great, and the microplastics, which is great, and ocean landfill, et cetera, great, I almost think it's apologizing for the fact it doesn't make any money.
Oh, I hope not, Mark.
I'm kind of on the fence about it, guys, so let's take it to a vote.
All right.
Attention, Kelly. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes!
Hi.
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 Mrs. Spinster?
Spinster Sisters.
Where's your sister?
My sister's in Colorado.
You're representing for the family, though.
Yes.
Okay. Your product speaks to me on a personal level because a lot of my initiatives have to do with sustainability and trying to do the best we can for this planet of ours, man. It's at a breaking point, man. So thank you for doing a good deed. I think we should open up the forum. You should, you know, elaborate a bit more about what you got going on.
Yeah, so I started this company a while ago with a more traditional personal care line. And in 2021, I launched our Free From line that's free from water and plastics. So we're not shipping water away around the country. Most lotions are 70 to 80% water. So ours are more concentrated, they last longer, they're more healing and great for your skin.
I have a question, but don't get me wrong. I am all for ecologically sound products. I've been an advocate for that for a long time. But I couldn't tell which was more important. Is this all about primarily being good for the planet and if you make some money, great? Or is this already a real business?
This is a real business. We're selling about 4,000 stores around the country. We are kind of teetering on profitability right now. Last year we had 5 out of 12 months that were profitable. but we have quite a lot of new business coming in this year that should get us squarely into profitability.
And give me a sense of the scale. What's the revenue?
Last year we finished at 1.8, and we're projecting about 3.5 million this year.
Entirely retail, or do you also do direct?
We have direct to consumer, but it's a really small piece of our business. It's primarily wholesale.
And what retailers are you in?
Kroger, Whole Foods, HEB, Safeway, Albertsons, PCC.
It's really impressive what you've built so far.
Thank you.
Have you raised any investment?
So I bootstrapped the company until last year. I did a crowdfund. So that was my kind of first foray into investment.
How much did you raise?
$267,000.
And today you're asking for?
$500,000 for 8% of my company.
8%?
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
And are you contract manufacturing?
No, we do our own manufacturing primarily.
Is this you in your kitchen at night, like filling bottles
with a
funnel?
It used to be, quite honestly. Our whole house became Spinster Sisters, but we're now in a 10,000 square foot warehouse.
But it's just you.
Well,
it's a lot of space.
16 employees, yeah.
Oh, that's what I was getting
at. Yeah, I'm sorry, okay. Yes.
Can we see the product?
Absolutely.
I was just about to ask.
I would love to. Brand new sticks. One is a hyaluronic acid and vitamin C, and one is a prickly pear and triple peptide. It's just a push-up on the bottom.
Are these some soaps as well?
Yes.
Okay.
We have soaps, shampoos, deodorants, moisturizers, scrub bars.
Can Mark try the lip balm? His lips are always dry. You're always on set saying your lips are so dry, Mark.
I'll give you a peppermint.
Now you are in trouble, because now I can speak twice as many words. I'm torn, because I'd love to support a business like this, but I'm scared because I don't understand a pure retail play. Not saying I don't understand it making sense, I just don't understand it personally. I can't see a clear path between my investment and a good return. I pass.
But Mark, you're—
Let's go back to before,
right? Before but, yes, your expertise in B2C could be hugely valuable,
yes,
in taking this business to the next level.
I pride myself, Kim, that for the first 25 years of my career, I never sold something face-to-face. When you go direct, give me a call.
All right.
I know how hard it is to scale a business and how much capital is required, especially since you don't even have a D2C strategy. So for me, I'd like to see a little bit more traction in order to be able to put money on this. Kelly, I'm gonna have to pass.
I can't make a professional decision off of a personal interest, and I do.
Yeah.
I would love to, but I wouldn't be in business long. But I agree with you both, and that's ultimately where I land as well. I have to be out.
Well, thank you for your time. Thank
Good
you
luck.
For the opportunity.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Stay strong, sister.
I do think the investors missed out on an opportunity. We're growing quickly, and again, we're a business as a force for good, and we're going nowhere but up, but I appreciate the opportunity for sure.
Well, listen, we didn't get to save the planet with that last one, but who knows what we're going to see next. You guys ready?
Ready.
Absolutely.
All right.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business, for every organization at every stage of growth. Soaring into the elevator, two entrepreneurs introducing an extravagant experience with their private jet company.
Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Mark, Kim, CeeLo. My name is Colin Jones.
And I'm Calvin Yoon. We're both founders of Amalfi Jets, a company we founded 3 years ago as 19-year-old college kids.
Amalfi Jets is a private jet charter brokerage. We don't own or operate any expensive aircraft, but simply arrange flights on behalf of our clients. We're currently signed vendors with 2 major motion picture studios, as well as we were featured in 2 Forbes articles and 1 Rob Report article.
Today, we're asking for a $500,000 investment for 3.3% equity at a valuation of $15 million.
Now, we think we're smart for our age, but we're not naive to say that we know everything. So the main reason we're raising capital is to bring on a partner that can mentor us as we scale the company and use those funds to build our own booking platform and app.
In 2020, our revenue was only $97,000, but in 2021, we made it $1.59 million. In 2022, we made it $2.85 million, had hit profitability, and our EBITDA was $160,000. And this year, year to date, we're already projecting $4.2 million.
There you have it. We look forward to chatting with you guys about Amalfi Jets in the boardroom.
Thank you, guys.
Absolutely.
Okay, I hate to be the contrarian here, but you know, you have all the way up to give a pitch, but doesn't mean you try and fit 3 times as many words in. This is like an Aaron Sorkin script.
Mark, it was a good pitch. They nailed every single point. I was very impressed.
I agree with Kim.
Well, listen, you guys are sharper than I am. I need it to go a little bit slower so I can absorb what they're saying.
I could use another private jet.
All right, well, let's vote.
Attention, Colin and Calvin. Your pitch has been approved.
Hell yeah.
How are you guys?
Great.
Hi, guys.
Thank you.
Connor and Calvin, you guys nailed that elevator pitch.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Congratulations.
Really appreciate that.
But we still have a lot of questions.
Yeah.
You started this at 19. How did you come up with this specific idea?
Yeah.
And what was the why?
That's a great question. So I actually got my pilot's license when I was 18 at Van Nuys Airport in California. So I was always around aviation, always fell in love with private jets, but obviously wasn't flying on private jets as a kid. I was at college, Calvin was back home. We were talking, this was during the pandemic, and I was like, you know, there's probably a huge push for people flying private right now in the pandemic. And you know, based on the research that we'd done, we called a bunch of other companies, and one of the biggest things that stood out to us was safety. Most of the other companies in the industry were not run by people that had any aviation experience. They were people that liked private jets, but weren't pilots, didn't have degrees in aviation, and didn't understand all the regulations behind it. So we put our minds together, started the company, and you know, essentially we made a website, made emails, emailed thousands of people every single day until one day someone responded.
Wait a minute, you're talking about actual jets. I thought you guys sold those little miniature jets right there.
actual private jets. So we're a broker, so we're very capital and asset light. We don't own or operate any aircraft. Every single aircraft, essentially 99.9% of the aircraft we utilize are owned by ultra net worth individuals. So what a lot of these people do, we'll lend these aircraft to Part 135 operators that are certified by the FAA. They're the ones hiring pilots, they're the ones training pilots, they're the ones maintaining and operating that aircraft, and essentially chartering it out to companies like us for hire to offset their ownership costs.
There are lots of jet brokers who
Correct.
Broker time. Are you just saying, hey, we're one more of 30, invest in us?
Not necessarily. So our main value prop as a company is on board every single flight. We provide complimentary black car service and our vendor cars that actually have the Amalfi Jets logo. Premium alcohol and catering, and as crazy as this sounds, we have a team of 6 people that literally fly around the world, meeting every single client at every single departure airport. So when you fly with us in Amalfi Jets, we control the entire process from start to finish, backed by our 24/7 operations team. Now, part of the reason that we're raising capital is to build out our own booking platform and simple app that would be proprietary. Essentially, we would sync directly up with the aircraft schedules, maintenance logs. So when you log into our app, if you remember, you can book an aircraft with guaranteed availability because we know when that aircraft's available.
But can't I do that right now?
Yes, you can do that right now. However, most of the big leading companies have problems where they have too many members, so they don't have enough physical aircraft in their own fleet to keep up with it.
Okay, so wait a minute. So what's the difference between what you do and something like JetSuite?
JetSuite's a great company, similar. Okay. They have, you know, modified Embraer 135s and 145s, but it's more of the semi-private, you know, fly-by-the-seat, where, you know, when you charter with us at Amalfi, you have the entire aircraft to yourself.
Got it.
And there's a beauty in not having your own fleet, as yes, it is good for us, as in we have no liabilities.
I'm gonna cut you off, because I don't care.
Yeah.
We've already established the fact you don't have your own fleet. I wanna know why you guys are a great business.
Of course.
Most of this probing, as you've kind of picked up, mm-hmm. is us trying to figure out what the hell you guys do.
They have a manual business that they're trying to automate through an app. Is that correct?
Yes. Correct.
Yeah, so you've done an amazing job
company,
getting to what
but
they
we're,
are.
We're not very tech-focused currently. So we want to build out this simple app to, one, streamline our current operations, make it a little bit more efficient. Obviously, it's easier to scale a tech company than, you know, much more manual business. However, by building out this proprietary tech where you can immediately book aircraft that already know if the aircraft are available, makes it easier and would give us a leg up on the other brokers that don't have that type of tech.
Okay, that I get.
Yeah, and how much have you raised so far?
We're bootstraps, and to this point, we've never raised capital before. You know, the first time we're raising is, one, to get a great new partner to mentor us as we scale, but also to, you know, have the capital actually build out that app and that platform, because tech's pretty expensive.
Okay, we'll talk about the numbers just for a second. Mm-hmm. So you're doing $4 million this year, and what's the margin on that? Is that you guys take a percentage of every flight? Is that the model?
We kept track of every single trip we've had, which is about 250, like all the deals. And then our average used to be, as you can tell, 2.85 million. We only made 160,000. That was a little less than 6%. This year we're on track to double that to about 12% every trip.
I'm struggling with the business model because right now I see how you can scale it even from where you are and double that again. Mm-hmm. But without the technology, and then that's going to cost a lot more than $300K to develop, speaking from my own experience of building many, many tech companies.
Yeah.
I'm just not sure how to bridge from where you are today to where you want to be.
Yeah.
So for that reason, I'm going to pass.
Thank you. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
You know, listen, for a pitch, you've got a limited amount of time. You have 60 seconds in the elevator. But then when you get to the boardroom, your time is limited too. Maybe you have 5 minutes or 10 minutes to make your case. And it took me 9 of those 10 minutes just to figure out what you guys are doing. And yes, finally, I got it. You're building a better jet brokerage.
Exactly.
Well, God, why didn't you say so? But as it is, I'm afraid I never learned enough. I wasn't given the time to probe more deeply. I pass.
Man, look, I got a gazillion sky miles on Delta. I'm medallion. I think I'm going to be out.
Appreciate your thoughts. Thank you guys so much for the feedback. Really appreciate it.
Thanks, you guys. Good luck.
Good luck to you guys.
I don't think that we had enough time in the boardroom to kind of explain the industry. I mean, you know, aviation is a very heavily regulated industry, so it would take a lot of time to go through how it works and, you know, kind of a little bit more on our model. I think we could have shared a little bit more on our model in the beginning just so it made sense to everybody, but overall, we got a lot of great feedback.
Gosh, I just wish I was able to start at that 9-minute mark. It's, I get it now, and there probably is a space for a better, more modern, more tech-enabled jet brokerage, but they just lost me before I got there.
They had me, but then they're gonna need a significant amount of capital to build that platform.
While only one entrepreneur was able to secure a high-flying deal, three were sent back down to the bottom floor with nothing to show. Whether it's a unique invention or a new way of living life, anyone could be 60 seconds away from rising to greatness or fall from glory. As we reach our midpoint to the season with a brand new episode you don't want to miss.
This has been a bloodbath.
You've only got 60 seconds to make your point. Don't blow it.
And to apply for the next season, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Investors personally styled by celebrity stylist Kim Bolafay.